Hello children, today we are going to learn about how to use he, she and it, where to use and how to use. Come, let's see. Now we use he to indicate a boy or a man. We use she to indicate a girl or a woman. We use it to indicate a place, an object, an animal. Now let me explain you in detail. As I told you, he indicates a boy and a man. So when we say he, we mean boy and a man. And boy can be your cousin. So we will say, he is my cousin. A boy can be your baby brother. So we will say, he is my baby brother. A boy can be your classmate or a friend. So we will say, he is my classmate or he is my friend. Same way, father. Your father is a man. So you will say, he is my father. Grandfather. Your grandfather is a man. So you will say, he is my grandfather. Similarly, for uncle. Your uncle is a man. So you will say, he is my uncle. Now this doctor is a man. So we will say, he is a doctor. So always remember, when we see a boy or a man, we will always use he. A man can be a gardener, painter, anyone. So when you see a boy or a man, you will use he. Now let's see, where do we use she? We use she, as I told you, when we indicate a girl or a woman. So she is used for a girl or a woman. So a girl can be your cousin sister. So you will say, she is my cousin. A girl can be a baby girl. So you will say, she's my little sister. A girl can be your classmate or a friend. So you will say, she is my classmate or my friend. Now, this woman is a doctor. So we will say, she is a doctor. Now, aunt, for your aunt also, we will use she. She is my aunt. For grandmother also, because she is a woman, so we will say, she is my grandmother. Your mother is also a woman. So for your mother also, we will use, she loves me. So always remember, when we are talking about a girl or a woman, we will always use she for them. Now let me tell you about it. As I told you, it indicates for animal, place and object. So when we talk about animal, when we talk about place and when we talk about any object, we will use it. Now this is a cat, so we will say, it is a cat. This is a school, so we will say, it is my school. This is a pot, so we will say, it is a pot. So we will use it when we have to talk about an animal or a place or a thing. To explain you better, let me give you some example. Read the word and circle the correct picture. Now the word is he, and there's a picture of a woman and there is a picture of a man. So he is used for a man, so we will circle man. Now next is the word is she, and there's a picture of a girl and there is a picture of a hat. She is used for a girl, so we will circle girl. Now it is written, and there's a picture of a man and an apple. So it is used for a thing, so we will circle the apple. Now let's see some more examples in a different way. Now look at the picture and write he, she and it. Now can you see the first picture? It is a picture of a park. Now park is a place. So for the place, as I told you, we write it. So we'll write it for the park. So it is a park. Now see the next picture. The next picture is of a woman. She's a grandmother. So we will write, she is my grandmother. See the next picture. It is a picture of a dog. And I told you, for animal, we write it. So we will say, it is a dog. Now let's see the last picture. It is a picture of a man, an uncle. An uncle is a man. So we will write, he is my uncle. I hope you have understood the concept of he, she, and it. So keep practicing. Bye-bye.